Okay, now we're going to do on this chapter called kinetic particle theory. There's another term for this. It also can be called the kinetic model of matter. Okay, now let's move on to the first slide. Now, matter can be existing in terms of solid, the liquid, or gas, any one of these three. And these three are actually also termed as the states of matter. Okay, so there are actually three states of matter that you are going to learn. Number one is solid, number two is liquid, number three is gas. Now, how do matter exist as solid, liquid, or gas? The things that we see around us, why are they solid, liquid, or gas? The key here is because we are classifying them based on three different things. The first one that we are classifying them based on their shape. Next one, volume and compressibility. These are the three different properties that we're going to talk about. How do we differentiate solid, liquid, and gas? So let's look at them. Now, for solid, they have fixed shape. If it's a square solid, it will be a square solid. Okay? For liquid, it's not fixed. When you put, for example, water in various containers, it takes on the shape of the container. So that's why it's not fixed. Same for gas. For solid and liquid, they have fixed volume, which means that if it's 100 cm cube solid or 100 cm cube liquid, you can't change the volume at all. Whereas for gas, you can actually change it. Okay? By compressing it. So you can see here, that's why gas is compressible, whereas for solid and liquid, they are not. So this actually is the way how we differentiate between all solid, liquid, and gas. Now, let's go on to talk about what's this really, this kinetic particle theory. We are saying that all matter is made of tiny particles, and these particles are in constant random motion. So just think of particles. Okay, it is always moving. Okay, always moving. Okay, you'll see particles like this, or sometimes you tend to draw them as, you know, like billet balls. They are just moving all the time in all direction randomly. Okay, now, why do we want to use the kinetic particle theory? It's because we use the kinetic particle theory to describe the states of matter. We will use it to describe solid, liquid, and gas. We'll use it to explain the differences in the properties of solid, liquid, and gas. So the differences. And then the last one, we'll use it to explain the change of state. What are change of state? Okay. It's like, for example, changing from solid to liquid. Okay. That's a change of state. This process, we all know, is melting. Okay. Melting. So just take note, kinetic particle theory, this is what we do for it. Okay, so this is the start, the introduction.